Okay, quick show of hands. How many people are here because of the beginner's makeup tutorial I did on Tuesday? Another show of hands. How many people have no idea what I'm talking about? I'm just kind of curious how you found this video. I find this stuff to be very fascinating. So hello, how are you? My name is Rachel. Also, you'll notice that my shirt is the same because as everyone expected, I was too lazy to change. So let's get into this. Hello everyone, I'm here today to share with you guys an intermediate makeup tutorial. If you watched last Tuesday's video, I did a really in-depth tutorial on this look right here using zero brushes and all drugstore products. And again, today we're gonna be using all drugstore products again, but it's more on how to build on this particular look. I have gotten so many requests from you guys to do this video, so I'm really excited that I finally get to sit down and share with you guys some tips and tricks and things for intermediates. I hope you guys find this video helpful. Give it a big thumbs up if you do, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. And without further ado, let's get into this. All right, now that we're zoomed in, we're gonna chat a little bit about different elements that I feel are sort of like intermediate level. Things that you can build on once you've kind of mastered all of the beginner stuff. Some of these are gonna be actually me applying the products, and others, like for example, the next thing I'm gonna talk about, which is primer, I'm gonna kind of talk through because, as you can see, I already have foundation on my face. But regardless, I'm gonna walk through everything in a lot of detail, share with you how much product to apply, where to apply it, when to apply it, and all of that stuff. But if you have any questions, as per usual, leave them in the comment section below. I would be happy to help, or I'm sure there's lots of others of you out there that may have gone through or asked the same questions and may have the answers, so feel free to share. It's a loving community here. So the first intermediate thing I want to talk about and things that you can build on to grow your makeup collection will be primers. In particular, face primers. This is a product that you're going to apply after you've applied all your moisturizers and skincare routine stuff, but before you apply any foundation. And essentially it's going to prime your face and get it ready and like smoothed out and everything for really seamless and flawless foundation application. So going over very quickly the types of primers that are available and which ones you should go for depending on your skin type. We'll start with dry skin. Look for something that has hydrating properties to it, moisturizing properties to it. That's going to really help to kind of boost the moisturizer you may have already applied to your skin, and it's going to make your foundation go on a lot easier and not look as patchy in certain dry areas. I also recommend looking for something that has like a highlighting effect. It may say illuminating or strobing or dewy, and that's just going to again give the illusion that your skin is very fresh and glowy, and I really like that. Personally, that's my favorite. If you have enlarged, it's basically like they have these little craters on skin. I get them like in this general area a lot. What a pore minimizing primer will do is just sort of fill them in temporarily and make it easier for your foundation to kind of sit on top very smoothly. And then lastly, if you have oily skin, look for something that is mattifying. That's going to help soak up any of the excess oils that you produce on your skin throughout the day and just make everything super matte. One of my personal favorites is by Milani. This is the Prime Light Face Primer. It is a strobing and a pore minimizing product, which means it has some illuminating properties to it, as well as sort of making all those big pores vanish. So you're gonna take a pea-sized amount like this, gonna rub it into your fingers, and then apply it the way you would a moisturizer, basically. Sometimes people prefer to pat it into the skin, some people prefer to rub it into the skin, and then you're gonna wait for it to dry a little bit before you go on to your foundation. And that's pretty much it. That is primer in like a nutshell. The next topic we're gonna talk about is bronzer. I didn't talk about this in the beginner's makeup guide, but I feel like for intermediates, this is something that a lot of people want to kind of step into without going into like the full contoured look. And so I'm gonna talk about today the butter bronzer. This is by Physicians Formula. As you can see here, I'm obsessed with it. Plus it smells like a tropical vacation, and I'm not mad at that. So first of all, I swirl my brush into the product, tap off any excess onto the lid, and that's just gonna make sure that I'm not like dumping a ton of product in like one central spot, because that is hard to blend out. And once I have product on my bristles, I'm going to apply it into a 3 and an E shape. So applying it here, and then underneath where the cheekbone is, so feel where your cheekbone is, just like at the outer edge of it, I find is the most natural. You don't want to bring it in too far. And then down and along the jawline here. And you can work all at once, you can go a little bit at a time. I personally like to go a little bit at a time and start with the temples. And then I'm using the side of the bristles here and applying it just underneath the cheekbone, which you can just feel with your finger there. And then bringing it down and along the jawline. I also recommend taking whatever is left on your brush and sort of blending it down into your neck, so you're going to eliminate any harsh lines, and make everything look really seamless. Then I like to take whatever is left over on my brush here and just sort of blend along the top of the hairline. Keep it as far up to the hairline as you possibly can. Bringing it down too low can look really muddy on the skin. Now I want to get into eyeshadows and how to apply them to the skin, which ones to invest in, things like that, because that whole area can be super overwhelming. So first, in terms of some of my favorites, number one has to be the CoverGirl True Naked Nudes palette. I talked about this in the last video, and honestly, I'm still all about it. I think it is a great quality product. It has a lot of different options in here. It has mattes as well as shimmers. They're super pigmented, really creamy and buttery. I love this palette. It also comes in goldens. It has rose as well as jewels. Like, there are different undertones to choose from. So this would be my number one. Another one I really like is by e.l.f. This is their Mad for Mattes palette. It is all matte shades, hence the name. But I find mattes are what I use on a regular basis anyway. It has a couple of different shades and tones of neutral shades for the crease down here. It has a lighter shade for the inner corner of the eye. And then once you start experimenting with makeup a little bit more, these gorgeous jewel tones up here and deeper colors are gorgeous, just kind of smudged along the lash line. We'll get into all of that later, but I really like this palette as well. So now let's get on to the actual application process. I've zoomed in a little bit so you guys can see what I'm actually putting on my eyes, but I want to start with a crease color. And a crease color is typically a matte shade because you're trying to make that whole area recede so that your eyelid is looking a little bit more prominent, as well as the brow bone. And the shade I would recommend to pick is a couple of shades darker than your natural skin tone. We'll use the e.l.f. palette as an example here, but we'll start with like this shade right here, apply it to the brush, and then you can see how much I have here. I tap off any excess. Can you guys see all the powder like flying off into the abyss? That will make sure that you don't get like chunks of eyeshadow all over your lids. Now for applying the product, if you watched my beginner's makeup tutorial, you saw I already put a little bit of concealer onto my lids. That's just going to give the shadow something to adhere to and make it a little bit more punchy, like you're gonna see the shadows a lot more. So I recommend starting there, but once that has dried down and set on your skin, then you can go in with the crease color. So I'm gonna look down, I'm gonna raise my eyebrows a little bit because I find that's gonna give me the most blended look, and I can get really into that inner part because I have a little tiny bit of a hooded lid. And then I'm going to sit it right into that spot. See right here how it's a little bit darker than everywhere else? That is where we're going to apply the shadow. So I'm going to start right in here. We're going to go small areas at a time. We're going to wiggle back and forth. I recommend just kind of starting here to start with, and then you can kind of experiment as you go. And then once that product is deposited there, I tend to wiggle it back and forth. You can work in little circular motions and then kind of work my way up a little bit, so that I'm blending everything out as smoothly as I can. Everyone's eye shape is a little bit different, and where you apply the shadow is gonna be a little bit different on everyone. That's something that I've learned through trial and error. So for example, for me, applying shadow more in like a backwards triangle area is really flattering for my eye shape. So just experiment until you find something that you really like, but that's a good general spot to start with, and then you can kind of build from there. Also to note, I'm not pushing really hard with my brush. I'm using very, very light strokes. I also tend to take a little bit more shadow, tap off excess again, and then apply it to the very, very outer corner of the eye. This is just, again, the most flattering for me, and I find it looks the most blended out at the end. And then we're gonna do the exact same thing on the other eye. I'm gonna raise my eyebrow a bit. You can see there, that is the darkest part. So that is where I'm going to concentrate the product. Now we're gonna go into a slightly deeper shade, and we're gonna apply that to the outer V. So I'm just gonna take this shade right here, tap my brush in it, tap off any excess, just the outer little piece along the lashes, and then up a bit to the crease, and then a little bit into the crease. That right here is the outer V. You can make it as thick or as thin as you want. You can see mine is getting a little bit on the thicker side. I find that to be very flattering on the eyes. And then once I've deposited all of the product that I want, then I'll start to blend it out with the blending brush that I used earlier. And I will just sweep it back and forth without any product on it, until it is nice and smoothly blended. I also like to take a little bit of the lighter shade right here on the pencil brush, wipe off any excess before you do this, tap off, and then apply a little bit just along the lower lash line. And I only really apply it a little bit over halfway and sort of blend out the rest as I get closer and closer to the inner corner. I don't drag the color all the way in because I find that tends to close off the eye a little bit. And then I like to complete the lower lash line with just a tiny little bit of mascara to the lower lashes. Now to go on to the world of brows. In the beginner's guide, I use a tinted brow gel, which is a great way of adding volume to your brows, but it's not great for any precise definition or areas that you want to fill in, which is what a pencil is good for. And today I'm gonna be using this one by L'Oreal. This is the Brow Stylus Definer. This is an ultra fine pencil, and this is great for adding in like pretend hairs basically into any areas where you're experiencing some patchiness. So first thing I do is I take the little spoolie on the other end and I will brush my brows up from the beginning and out this way. And the general rule for shaping your brows is you take a brow pencil or anything really, line it up from the outside of the nostril to the tip of the brow, and that'll be the outside point. Then go to the middle, it should go directly through the eye, and then from the outer nostril to the outside of the eye, and that's where the brow should end. So that's sort of like a good general starting point for shaping your brows. If you are brand new to brows and you have no idea how to start, I recommend going into an expert and talking to them and having them shape your brows for you to start. That's a really good idea to get them all waxed and perfect and the right shape, and then you can just clean it up as you go from there. But in terms of filling them in, once I've brushed them all into place, I'll look for any areas that are patchy. So for example, for me, it's back here. So I have a little bit of a patchiness area right in here, and I have some patchiness right under here as well. So I will just start with like little tiny brush strokes, not pressing too hard, especially near the front. You want the front to be a little bit softer and less defined than the back end of the brow. So I'm going really, really softly up at the front, little brow hairs. I'm not going past where sort of the brow hair starts, so down here. And then starting about one third of the way in, I will start brushing in a shape, like a line in here, to create the bottom arc of my brow, like so. Sometimes another thing that I do, I've never seen anyone else do this, but it works really well for me, is I will see where the line is that I wanna create, and I'll brush these hairs down so that I can like fill it in properly. Cause sometimes I find that my brow hairs get in the way and I can't fill them in properly. And then when I brush them back, it like fills it in beautifully. So a little trick that maybe will work for you, I don't know. And you can see right there, I have a little bit of a bald spot after brushing my hairs up. So I will just take that and just apply it in little strokes. And then the last thing I want to share with you guys is eyeliner. If you have never bought an eyeliner before and you don't really know how to apply and where to start, I want to kind of talk about that here. And the product I'm going to be using today is by Revlon. This is their 2-in-1 angled liner, and it's really cool because on one end it's got this little like, I don't know, rectangular shaped kind of eyeliner. And then on the other end, it has this like little brush, and it makes it really easy to kind of create more of a smoky appearance. And by doing so, you're going to blend out the eyeliner a lot better, and it's gonna look a lot smoother, especially if you're new to liner. Sometimes, like at least for me, when I was applying, it would get really bumpy and ridgy, and I'm like, first, like look down at a mirror, and I would start at sort of the outer third of the eye. So right where the eye begins to curve, that's where I would start creating a bit of a line. I also recommend applying this before you put on your mascara. This is gonna be tricky. And I'm just gonna do tiny little strokes here, applying that liner right up against the lash line. You want to eliminate the space between where your lash roots are and where the liner is. Because if you create a line that's too far above it, you're gonna see your skin beneath, and that's not really what we're going for here. So create it as close as possible to that lash line. And then once you've applied it, you just take this little brush and then you're just gonna sweep it along to smooth everything out. It's just gonna make it a little bit smoother. It's going to smoke it out a bit. It's not gonna make it bumpy at all, especially if you're a beginner. This just takes a lot of the guesswork out of it. And there you have it, an intermediate makeup guide. I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. I hope you're all having a wonderful, wonderful week so far. Don't forget to check out my beginner's makeup guide if you missed that one last Tuesday. And that's everything. I hope you guys are having a wonderful, wonderful week so far, and I will see you guys all in my next video. Love you, girls. Mwah.